All right, it's Percy, and here's my user. So this is user scenario one.
Okay, the user wants a citrus body lotion. I'm going to go to the lotions, add it to the cart, and check out. Here's my home page. I'm going to go to body. Then my body page is lotion, and I'm going to go to the organic orange and cranberry lotion. Then under the body lotion, I'm going to add it to the cart up here, and the pop-up says thank you. I got the orange and cranberry lotion added to the cart. And then I got the checkout preview. No coupons. I'm going to proceed to the checkout right here. And I see the cart information. All my stuff is there. And I'm going to finish the purchase right there. And a pop-up says, thank you for your purchase. I'm going to print out the receipt.
All right. Thank you. Is there anything I really need to improve on, or as far as the website, how the
user... I understood everything. Just at the beginning, I wasn't sure whether it was skin or body, but I figured it was body because it's a lotion, a body lotion. So.
Okay. I definitely need to clarify. I mean, the skin is supposed to be for like acne stuff and stuff like that, but I definitely need to clarify that a little bit more, I think, instead of just putting skin, because skin is body. So, all right, thank you for the feedback.
You're welcome.
All right, this is user scenario number two.
All right, I'm going to create an account. I'm going to find a member login and sign up to be a member. Okay, member up here. And then I'm going to do a member. I'm going to create an account right here. So create an account. I need to... I'm going to put email, phone number, address, my card information, and then I'm going to finish and send confirmation. Thank you for becoming a member. Confirmation code sent. Email inbox for the cosmetics, and there's the confirmation code and my member up there. All set. Continue shopping. Now I can shop.
All right. What did you think I needed to improve?
I think it was pretty self-explanatory how to I didn't know whether up here I was supposed to put my username or password in, but that's afterwards. So.
Okay. Do you think I should, like, once I get to the email, I realize when you're doing it that...
I didn't put in...
No. Like, when you get to this page, this email...
Uh-huh.
I realized that it's like once you click it, you have nothing to go to. So I need to make it like a blank browser that sets you back instead of having a pop-up, for sure.
Right.
So instead of having a pop-up, so.
Yeah. Okay.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
All right. So this is user scenario three.
Okay. The user needs a dry foundation. And under the makeup tab, I'm going to look for the skin tone and the type to get the proper one, and then I'm going to buy it. There's makeup right there on my homepage. Okay, I got my filters, and then I'm gonna filter, I'm gonna do the foundation, I'm gonna do dry and save. And then I'm gonna do filter. I'm going to do the hydrating 24-hour foundation right here. And then I have the liquid foundation with skin tone checked, and I'm going to add to my cart, and then it says, thank you, it's added. And then I'm gonna review my checkout, and I'm gonna proceed to checkout. And then I'm gonna look over the information, see how much the total is, and I'm gonna finish the purchase. Thank you for your purchase. I'm gonna print the receipt.
All right, cool. Is there anything for this one, do you think? I have to improve on.
I wasn't sure about the type. I knew the skin tone, but I guess the type is the foundation itself.
By dry, I meant like type of skin. So people can have like oily and dry skin.
Right.
And combination skin. So I was going for like dry skin, so a hydrating one, but
that's the type, then.
I'll definitely make sure I definitely put skin before skin color and then skin type, because that makes it more clear.
Right. Sure. Okay.
All right. Thank you.
You're welcome.
All right. This is a user scenario 4.
Okay. User needs an oil-free shampoo. I'm going to browse the hair tab to get an oil-free shampoo, and I'm going to purchase the product. Our hair is right there on my home page, and then I'm going to press this for the organic lemon oil free shampoo.
So I guess it was confusing. I need to make sure that I clarify that you need to have filters first. I'll need to clarify that, but
okay. And then I got the oil lemon, organic lemon oil free shampoo, and I'm going to add it to the cart. Thank you, added is a pop up. And then I'm going to review the checkout, and I'm going to proceed to checkout. And then I have my checkout information with my total amount, and then I'm going to finish the purchase. And my purchase page says, thank you for your purchase. I'm going to print the receipt.
All right. Thank you. I definitely need to clarify on the filters.
Yes.
So.
Yeah, because it just says to get an oil-free shampoo. Yeah. But I didn't know there was different types that were going to be on there.
Yeah. I guess I had, like, dry hair, oily hair, and then, like, curly hair. So,
oh, okay.
As different, like, filter options. Uh-huh. So I definitely need to make it more obvious that I would want you to do filters first. Mm-hmm. Just because doing all the hair products would be way too much. Because there's not just shampoo also. There's, like, you know, there could be different hair products that
right.
are on the website. So All right. Well, thank you for the feedback.
You're welcome.
All right. So this is user scenario number 5.
Okay. The user wants to investigate events to join. That should be interesting. Scroll down to the footer and find the future events section and browse. Then book one for the weekend. Okay, I'm going to scroll down and I find my future events. Okay, under future events, I want to this weekend 1K run charity, and I'm going to book. Okay, it's booked. Email was sent to remind you. Oh, that's good.
Did you think that there is anything, you know, I know these were only like a couple pages, so did you think there's anything missing? There could have been an extra step, maybe?
No, I mean, if you're just booking an event, you browse through them, you're just going to pick one and book it, so it's okay. Easy. There's not a whole lot of steps to do that.
Okay. Because I was thinking it might have been confusing that there was no filters or anything, but I guess the idea is I would definitely want to build a website where the stuff that is coming up the soonest is first.
Yeah.
That would be like an always, you know, like a
Yeah, because you can't really have so many different events.
Events, yeah.
It wouldn't, people would get tired of scrolling down.
Yeah, yeah. But to have them in order definitely was my idea. So that's why I didn't really think of a filter. But
for
then,
this weekend, yeah. Just events for this weekend, so you wouldn't have as many.
Yeah. So I definitely could make like a filter where it's like, to sort it at least, to where it's the dates are in order. So not necessarily a filter, but maybe to sort it. You know, last to first, first to last, right, sort of thing. Mm-hmm. All right, cool. Thank you for the suggestion.
You're welcome. All right.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome.